name's Alan Hart, and today we've got two Viessmann boilers that I'm going to strip down. So we've got a 30 kilowatt Viessmann combi boiler here, which is it's a WB1B, and then we've got a 35 kilowatt system boiler. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to strip these both down, and I'm going to show you all the parts inside them. This one is a 35 kilowatt WB1C, so we'll strip that down as well. So I'll strip them both down and we'll have a look inside them and see all components that you see in these boilers. So this video is aimed really at new recruits into the industry, just to give you an idea of what's inside boilers. It's not meant as any sort of training video, and always remember, if you work on any boilers, you must be gas safe registered. So you have to be gas safe registered to work on gas boilers. First of all, what we'll do is I'll just show you a little look around in here, just some of the other boilers that I've got on show. So I'll have a look at that now. The Baxi Neatatec there, which I've totally stripped to bits. We've got three Ideologics there, and then we've got the Viessmann ones there, which we're going to take apart now in a few minutes. We've got a Valent boiler, we've got a Worcester boiler, a Worcester Bosch, that were a Worcester Bosch CDI that I've stripped down, and then we've got a new Baxi 600, again that's been fully stripped down as well. So all these boilers are just demo boilers, just for testing and cutting up and playing with, really. And then I've got all bits of, so it's a total mess in here, so I've just got all bits of, just bits of boilers everywhere. Heat exchangers, expansion vessels. Right, okay, so let's get into these boilers here now and start stripping them down. So first of all, to take the cases off on these boilers, we've got two screws just under here. So there's one on this side, and then there's one on this side here. So on this one here, they've already been undone, under there. And then all we need to do then is, once you've undone the two screws underneath, you can just lift the case off. So there's the two boilers inside. So we've got a heat exchanger there. We've got the fan, and we've got the gas valve, and then the same in that one. So we've got gas valve, fan, and heat exchanger. So we've got this expansion vessel there, and then same in that one as well. So what we'll do, we'll strip this one down now, and we'll have a look inside. So they're very easy to strip down, these boilers. So to take the burner door off here, we've just got some bolts to unscrew, just on here, four bolts, and then we've just got to undo a gas valve, and we've got to take electrical connections off on here and on the fan. So we'll do that now. So just to be careful on this, because that's got your washer in there for your gas valve. So that's obviously not been off for a while, so I should imagine this hasn't been serviced since it was installed. So that's all your burner, your electrodes there, look. So if you're going to strip one of these down, you check this seal in here, and then you may need to change that. You'd have to have a look in manufacturer instructions just to double check. And then let's have a look inside boiler. So if you have a look inside this, this clearly hasn't been serviced since it's been installed. So if we have a look at this one on this side, that's a lot cleaner. So that's obviously been serviced more often than the one on the left. So now we'll take the heat exchanger out on this. So we'll just take off this hose. So I've removed the hose and there's just a few bolts to undo. So there's one there, one at that side at back, just there, and then one there as well. And then we can just unclip the back hose from there. Now bear in mind this boiler's fully drained down, it's not connected to the system at all. There's also this pipe to come off on bottom there. So I've undone the screws at the top of the flue here. Just pull that out away. And then that'll make it easier just to lift this heat exchanger forward. You see there, I'll just lift out and get all the wires off it. So we'll have a little look at that heat exchanger in a little while. First of all, we'll take out the expansion pencil. Normally I'd use adjustables, but this is not going to be bolt back together, so just remove expansion vessel out of that. So in this particular boiler you've got an 8-litre expansion vessel in there. So to lift this bottom flap down, we've just got a clip on this side and we've got a clip on this side, and then that will just open down like that. And just lift that out away that we took off earlier. And then you've just got your pump in there. You've got your auto air vent. You've got your blow off there. So if you needed to change that, you could just change that from there. And then you've got all your diverter in there. You've got a blanking plate there. So if that had a, must be if that had a plate heat exchanger. So in this one clips are a bit different, so it's on that side, it's same on that side. But if you see the difference there, the plate on the back of that one compared to that one. So that's just got a plastic instead, just probably to hold it together, give it a bit of strength. So then you've got your condensate trap at the back on that one. And then on this one, condensate trap is at the front, which is a bit easier. I'm not going to strip all that down, I don't see the point. So if we just have a quick look at the heat exchanger, you can see stainless steel, so it's a good quality heat exchanger is that. Right guys, so that's just a little look inside your VIESSMANN 100 combi boiler and system boiler. I hope that was of some interest and some use to anybody who's managed to get to the end of this video. Thank you for watching, thanks for taking the time to watch these videos. If you like them, please subscribe. If you've got any questions, please add them in comments below. And if you need any more information on any of these two boilers here, just ask me. I can strip something else down and do another video if need be. So yeah, thanks for watching.